everyone. Today I'm reviewing Madame Lala Self Tan Mousse. After trying this mousse, I give it 2.5 out of 5 stars, so I find it to be very average. I know a lot of you have requested that I try this one, and I finally got around to it, so I'll tell you all about it right now. This one's $38.50 for this bottle, and the bottle is 7 ounces. So that works out to almost $6 an ounce. $6 an ounce, which is a little on the pricier side, but nothing outrageous. $38 sounds really expensive, but when broken down per ounce, it's not as expensive as it sounds. And this is a mousse, and it comes out with a dark brown guide. It's kind of greenish looking, and you could tell I got some product on it, the top, and it definitely dries like bright green, and I got some on the lid and it's definitely green, but when you put it on your body, it's kind of more of a dark brown, almost orangey look. The mousse has a nice texture. It's not too thick, not too thin. And this product smells pretty good. It has a rich coconut smell, which I love. I love tropical smelling products, but it also has a hint of something underlying that I don't like, and it's a little bit sour. I think it's the DHA, the self-tanner I'm smelling in there. But overall, it smells better than most self-tanners, and I really like the smell. But by the next morning, the smell had definitely gotten worse. I could smell more self-tanner, more of that sour smell. I could also smell some coconut still, but it definitely didn't smell as good the next day as it did when I applied it. As far as applying this one goes, I used a mousse just to protect my hands from the dark brown guide, and it also made it easier to apply. There's nothing really special or difficult as far as applying this one goes. It blended into my skin nicely when I used a mitt. Easy to rub in, it was pretty quick to apply. The guide helps you see where you're applying it, which is always nice. And it absorbed into my skin nicely. Now, the drying time was a little bit better than average, your average mousse. Your average mousse takes about 40 minutes to dry and you feel pretty sticky while it dries. This one took about 25 minutes to dry, so I'm happy with that. It did still feel a little sticky while I waited for it to dry, but I've come to expect that with mousses. They mostly all feel sticky. That doesn't mean I like it, but this one is better than your average mousse. Now, as far as the results go, so this one is very confusing as far as how to use it. On the bottle, it says to leave it on for at least 10 hours before showering, but on their website, it says to leave it on for 3 hours before showering. So they kind of need to get their crap together and decide what the directions for this product are. I ended up following the directions on the bottle and left it on for at least 10 hours. So I left it on overnight while I slept. I tried this in their original shade. They also have a light one. So this is the darker of the two. By the next morning, once I showered it off, I had a really wonderful tan. I loved how it looked. It was brown. I had a dark sun-kissed look. It was pretty dark. I liked how dark it was. But that sadly only lasted a day. By the second day, my tan had completely changed colors. It was orangey, unnatural, patchy, especially in my arms, like right in here. It looked so bad, and you could definitely tell that I had fake tan. I don't really experience it that often where my tan changes dramatically by the second day. But this one definitely did, and I don't know why, but by the second day it just looked so fake and orange, and I didn't like the color. This one's a darker self-tanner, so you be careful if you have pale, very pale skin to begin with. Once I had washed my product off the next morning after applying it, I had initially planned to rank this one a lot higher because I loved my tan, but by the second day I just really wasn't a fan of it. It looked so bad that I had to knock it down a little bit. It's too bad because that first day it looked really, really good and I looked so natural and sun-kissed. I really liked it. This one lasts for 6 days, but it doesn't look good those whole 6 days. It looks good for like a day and a half before it starts fading really unevenly. It gets patchy. It turns like an orangey color. So that was unfortunate. Men, I'm not sure that you would like this one. The first day you'll like it, but then after that it gets not as good. So I think that there are better self-tanners out there for you looking for a dark tan. But yeah, so I think it's pretty average self-tanner. If my tan would have stayed how it looked that first day, I would have ranked it higher, but unfortunately it didn't. So I gave this one 2.5 out of 5 stars. I wanna know if you guys are using this one, what you think of it. Make sure to comment below. Or if you have another self-tanner you want me to test out, you can comment that as well. And for more information on this self-tanner and many others, please visit us online at SelfTanning.com and on social media.